Happy Day Children, our transdisciplinary theme is How We Express Ourselves. And that is, it is an inquiry into the ways in which we discover and express ideas, feelings, nature, culture, beliefs and values, the ways in which we reflect on, extend and enjoy our creativity, our appreciation of the aesthetic. A central idea is the elements of art allows people to convey ideas and explore. Our lines of inquiry is elements in visual art. In our today's session, we are going to learn about still life drawing. So what is still life drawing? Still life drawing is a drawing or painting that focuses on still objects. The subject matter is inanimate and never moves, typically with a focus on household objects, flowers or fruits. Here are some of the examples of still life drawing. In this drawing, our key concepts are form, function, and connection. Form is that it is three-dimensional in form. Function is that it focuses on still objects. And the connection is that it shows us a new way of looking at the ordinary objects around us. So can we start our still life drawing? Today in our still life drawing, we are going to draw a jar. And for that, first we'll draw a 12 cm of straight line and then add up with a 2 cm, 4 cm and 5 cm and 2 cm in our jar drawing. In our drawing, first we'll draw a oval-shaped circle and then add up the lines with the measurement we have done, which gives us a shape of a jar. For still life drawing, we should learn about the measure of the subject, and that is what we have done here. After drawing with the measurement, we'll erase the lines which we have used for the measurement. After measuring our subject, we'll start drawing the shapes in it, and then we will delineate the shadow edges. So we'll add up with the value in the edges. The term still life is derived from the Dutch word stilleven, which gained prominence during the 16th century. Still life drawing makes our overall better at drawing. They are a great way to practice creating shapes and building three-dimensional forms through shading techniques of realistic lighting. Once we add up the value, we'll merge the dark shade with the finger. After merging, we'll give the dark shade for our top part of the jar. And then adding up the lines in it. Now for making it to be on some table or something, we'll add up with a dark shade from the edges of the jar, and that is by giving a straight line with the 3/4 of the jar. And then in that we'll add a value for giving it as a background. At the edges, we'll give a dark shade in one side and a light shade in the other side, so that it gives us a realistic look of a still life drawing. And finally, we'll merge it with our finger. This is my understanding of still life drawing, and I have done a jar. You can draw any object which feel you that it gives a still life look. It can be a mug or a cup or a glass or a water bottle, anything. And finally, we'll add up the shadow in our bottom part of the jar. So we have done our still life drawing. In this, our approaches to learning is thinking skills and research skills. We are developing our thinking skill by revising and learning more about shape, color, light, shadow, composition, and that we are implementing by developing our observation skills and then creating in our artwork with research skills. That is why our learner profile attributes are thinker and inquirer. Our learning outcome is to develop the understanding with the still life drawing and to explore our creativity with still life in our artwork. Once you finish your artwork, take a pic of your work and upload it. Thank you, children.